created. This component is an all-in-one wardrobe and works beautifully. All the parameters are flexible and the output is unbelievable. I hope you like it. Take a look. I'll change all the parameters and show you. Here is a wardrobe that is 1200 millimeters wide, 600 deep and 2100 height. Let me start by changing some parameters. You can look at the dimensions to see how the wardrobe changes. Let's make this an 1800 mm wide component. There you go, you can see the dimensions have changed. Let's increase the height to 2400. And you see the instant result. Now, suppose it was a 1200 by 2100 component. Back again. You can see how I can adjust even the skirting height. So here you go. So I can make it zero. There, no skirting. I can make it 75 mm. And the whole skirting is redrawn, the dimensions are checked, changed, shutter sizes are remapped. Then we can move to the carcass thickness. Now, this particular model is built to the carcass thickness of 18 mm. Let's change it to 25 mm and see the result. There you go. Now, the carcass is 25, the model dimensions remain the same. You can see that it's still a 1200 millimeter cabinet. So after changing the carcass to 25, both sides of the unit are now 25 mm and or top and bottom are 25 mm, but the dimension has remained 1200 mm. Now let's take a look at how even the reveal is controlled. So I have here a reveal of, well, let's say the shutter. You want to make a thicker shutter, then you just enter the figure and the shutter sizes will change. The shutter thicknesses will change. And here is the reveal. I'll show you the reveal. That is the overlap that is left. So there you go, 6 mm is the reveal that I asked for. Now it's become 6 mm, that is the shutter is 6 mm away from both edges of the carcass. Usually in production we leave it at 2.5 mm, so I change it back to 2.5. And currently my dimensioning style is set to accuracy of 0.1. Let me change it to precision of, you should be able to see the accuracy of the reveal, 2.5 mm, let's make it 3.5, there you go. Now you can see the accuracy has changed. It is just a display factor. Let me put it back to 2.5, which is the actual production. It's 2.5 again, and here we can control the back and the back thickness and the back distance. So distance of the back, we usually keep 12 mm gap at the back, so that's the 12 mm gap, and the back thickness is usually 8 mm, so I can change the back thickness. So this is an incredibly dynamic component. I can change it to 2400, and that means that the shutters are 1200, and that's not good. So we'll give it number of shutters. We'll make this a 4-shuttered unit. To take a look inside, what is happening inside the cabinet? Let's remove the shutters for a while, make them zero. Here now you have packing sides to the drawer, which is I used to control the ease of opening after the hinges. The drawers don't collide with the hinges. So let's make it 75. That's your packing sides. I have increased in size. Then let's make the drawer columns as two columns. And let's make the drawer rows as three rows of drawers. Now, where is my mid shelf? This is mid shelf. Let's say I want to make it at 800 millimeters. There it goes up and the drawers resize automatically. Now, what about my fixed mid shelf? This is my fixed mid shelf, which I made at 800 mm. And the top shelf, usually I keep it at 1800. Let's say I want it a little lower at 1750. There, it gets recalibrated, recalculated, it comes down. And this gap between the shelves on top also reduces. If I wanted just two rows of shelves in the middle, or if I didn't want any. Bingo, it just keeps magically transforming. And let's say there's a couple of more options. Mid vertical, it says alert. Mid vertical is required because of 2400. The span is quite long, so it needs some support. So how many mid verticals? Currently we are giving one. You could add maybe three and more verticals get added, or you could just leave it as one. Fixed mid shelf, fixed internal columns, internal rows, fixed mid verticals, back to one. Now, we can close this, back to four shuttered unit. And there you go. You have a beautiful 2400 by 2100 wardrobe. Now the beauty of this is that this doesn't end here. It can become many wardrobes or many pieces of furniture, as many as you can imagine. I'll just show you by adding another component next to it. So this could be a tall unit. So let's say it's width is 450 mm. And we don't want any shutters on it, so it's just an open unit, and therefore I need to change the number of drawers, etc. I don't want any drawers on it, though automatically the drawer packing sides have gone. I need let's leave the fixed mid shelves the same as the wardrobe next to it and the top shelf. Internal shelf columns, rows, let's add four shelves. And I don't need a mid vertical, it's very small. And as you can see, that mid vertical alert says mid vertical is not required. There you go. And the columns, number of internal shelf columns becomes one. So where it was split is now all joined up. This way, I can create a combination wardrobe that is designer, aesthetic, and is not limited to the controls that we have given it in here. So let's put in one more shutter on the side, which is 600 mm, sorry, 60 mm, it would be wrong, but 600 mm. There you go. Or it's just simpler to delete this. Delete. Just change this component because I want a 600 millimeter component with a single shutter. That's all I need. So here, this shutter. Now, what if I needed to have even further variations? I have created a few components already. things mixed in here. So there are four types of wardrobes that you or components that you usually require in as wardrobe spaces: the solid shutter, open units, aluminum profile hinged units, and then there are sliding cabinets. So there's solid sliding and there is a aluminum profile sliding. A combination of these can give you an entire wardrobe. If it's an open wardrobe, we just need to remove the shutters. And bingo, there you have it. A beautiful, dynamic, flexible component system which removes the tedium of drafting and redrafting and correcting of sizes and is absolutely accurate and production ready. That's the beauty of these dynamic components. Hope you guys love the flexibility of it and create your own dynamic components and have a sped up drawing process. Thanks for watching.